8 reasons you have foot pain and how you can fix it with home remedies. It's so vital to take care of your feet. They are an intricate physiological framework that we continuously rest our entire body weight on. Foot pain, therefore, can interfere with your day-to-day life in an uncomfortable and irritating way. Whether your feet feel discomfort in your heels, in your toes, or in the arch of your foot, you should attempt to recognize the cause of the pain as well and treat it promptly, even if you simply take interim action in your home. Here, you'll review reasons for various foot pain and the best natural course of treatment. 1. Flat feet, fallen arches. Individuals with flat feet, additionally known as fallen arches, are where your feet press flat on the ground. They're common and normally nothing to worry about. If flat feet are causing pain, then wearing well-fitted footwear can help. Extra wide-fitting shoes can give relief. Fitted insoles, as well as orthotics or custom-designed arch supports, might relieve pressure on the arch and also lower discomfort. 2. Plantar calluses. Plantar calluses are tough, thickened skin that forms on the surface of the bottom of your foot, the plantar side. This is the thick band that links your heel bone to your toes. Although they're your body's way of safeguarding your feet from friction, they can at some point trigger a bit of extra discomfort. Plantar calluses are very common and are treatable. You can apply over-the-counter callus remover pads. Soak your hands or feet. Soaking your hands or feet in warm soapy water softens corns and calluses. File thickened skin. Hydrate your skin by moisturizing. Put on comfortable footwear as well as socks. 3. Sprains and strains. A sprain is a stretching or tearing of ligaments. Ligaments are tough bands of fibrous tissue that link one bone to another. Typical areas for strains are your ankle joints and also knees. A strain is typically brought on by trauma to a joint. Symptoms of sprains and strains include discomfort, swelling, bruising, and also lowered series of motion. A strain is generally the outcome of overstretching or overuse of muscles and tendons. People at greater risk of sprains and also strains consist of professional athletes, people that have had strains previously, and those who are obese. Rest the injured area. Discomfort is the body's signal to stagnate an injury. Ice the injury. This will limit the swelling as well as help with the spasm. Compress the area that is injured and raise it up high. Take care not to wrap the area so firmly that it could prevent blood flow. Over-the-counter pain medication is an option. Advil or naproxen help ease inflammation. Bear in mind to adhere to the guidelines on the bottle for the ideal dosage. 4. Achilles tendonitis. The Achilles tendon connects the calf muscle mass to the heel bone and runs down the lower leg. When this tendon is put under excess strain, it can end up being irritated. The primary signs and symptom of Achilles tendonitis is discomfort and also swelling in the backside of your heel when you stroll or run. Minimize your physical activity. Stretch your muscles really gently, and try to strengthen your calf muscles. Partake in less strenuous sporting activities. Ice the area after exercising or when in pain. Wear a brace or walking boot to stop movement in the heel. Visit a physiotherapist. Take anti-inflammatory medicine, such as aspirin, buferin, or ibuprofen, Advil, for a restricted time. Wear footwear with a built-up heel to take the stress off your Achilles tendon. If you find home treatment does not work, it's important to see a doctor. If your tendonitis worsens, your tendon can tear. You may need drugs or surgery to reduce the discomfort. 5. Ingrown toenail. When a nail is ingrown, it is rounded and also grows into the skin. This digging in of the nail aggravates the skin, often developing discomfort, inflammation, swelling as well as heat in the toe. If an ingrown nail triggers a break in the skin, bacteria may enter and trigger an infection in the area, which is determined by the toe seeping as well as a foul smell. Even if these symptoms are not displayed, a nail that grows downward right into the skin can progress into an infection. Fill up a large container with 8 liters of warm water. Include a number of spoonfuls of salt and also mix until the salt dissolves. Soak the foot for 15 to 20 minutes every day. Warm water softens the skin around the ingrown toenail, while the salt fights the infection and reduces swelling. After you have actually soaked your feet, clean off the salt with fresh, warm, soapy water. Rinse and allow your feet to dry. Put on a clean pair of socks every day. You can minimize the risk of infection if you keep them as clean as possible. 6. Gout arthritis pain. Gout is a type of arthritis. Joint inflammation occurs in which small crystals develop inside the body, especially around the joints. It triggers unexpected attacks of extreme pain as well as swelling. It's estimated that between 1 and 2 people out of 100 in the UK are affected by gout pain. The condition generally affects males over 30 and females after the menopause. A sudden, unexpected attack of gout arthritis frequently strikes during the evening or early hours in the morning. It can become extremely painful, quite quickly, where even the touch of clothes on the affected joint become unbearable. The skin might be red, as well as glossy, and the swelling may be so severe that the skin may peel. A mild fever. A loss of appetite and also a sensation of fatigue can also come with acute attacks of gout arthritis. Some people never experience more than one attack. But if the uric acid remains high, the majority of people will have a second attack between 6 months and 2 years after the initial one. Attacks that are untreated can result in damage to the cartilage and bone, causing deformity. Apple cider vinegar. Raw unfiltered ACV is essential when treating gout. It's an all-natural remedy. ACV helps your body become more alkaline and the acidity helps eliminate gout pain. Consume 1-2 tablespoons a day, diluted in an 8-ounce glass of water. It is known to decrease inflammation. Some people drink this 2-3 times a day for much better outcomes. ACV can be used as a topical treatment. You should soak the affected foot for 30 minutes in a container, with 4 cups of warm water and 1 cup of ACV. Additionally, you can soak a piece of cloth in apple cider vinegar and wrap it around the affected area for about 15 minutes. Ginger root. Ginger root is understood to be effective at treating gout due to its anti-inflammatory properties. It's been discovered to be mildly reliable in relieving the pain in inflamed joints. You can use ginger in cooking dishes or use ginger root with boiling water and drink as a tea. Ginger root can be used topically. Apply it as a paste to alleviate pain connected with gout arthritis. Baking soda. Baking soda is similar to apple cider vinegar. It boosts the alkaline in the body. To relieve the discomfort from gout, dissolve 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda in water and drink several glasses each day. Sodium bicarbonate decreases the amount of uric acid in the body, which alleviates pain. You should seek advice from your health practitioner if you suffer from high blood pressure or need to monitor your salt intake before using this treatment technique. Lemon juice. Experts claim adding lemon juice to 8 fluid ounces or 225 milliliters of cold water can help in decreasing the uric acid levels. However, it is recommended that taking vitamin C tablets could be absorbed by the body faster. Cherries. Cherries also contain vitamin C, which has been shown to contribute to lower degrees of uric acid. Turmeric. Turmeric is also effective at lowering inflammation and can be included in cooking dishes. 7. Heel spurs. Heel spurs are growths of bone on the bottom of your heel. Wearing badly fitted footwear, bad posture, or running can cause it. Heel spurs doesn't cause everyone pain, and in fact, is quite common. Relaxing your feet is the ideal treatment to combating heel spur discomfort. Water bottle ice pack can help to soothe the pain and control swelling and inflammation. Rolling it under your foot for 10-15 minutes, when you feel the discomfort coming on. Epsom salt bath. Soaking yourself in a warm Epsom bath can soften your heels. It can also lower inflammation and swelling, and also relieve heel spur pain. 8. Plantar fasciitis. The high stress and strains we place on our feet are supposed to be absorbed by the plantar fascia. But, in some cases, too much pressure can damage the tissue. The body's all-natural response to injury is swelling, which results in the heel discomfort and tightness of plantar fasciitis. The best course of treatment is to rest your foot and to put on footwear with a cushioned sole and great arch support. Thank you for watching my video. Like, comment and subscribe.